Good morning children. Yes, it is my second video, myself Gayatri, that is class 7th subject science. So I am going to taking second lesson of class 7th, that is what? Nutrition in plants. Yes, so let us move on with this topic. So first we will discuss about the introduction. Okay, so as you all know that in class 6th you have learned about how plants can prepare food. Yes, how they can prepare their own food, how they can prepare their food by the process of photosynthesis. What about animals and we human beings? We cannot prepare our own food. Yes, we are depend upon other plants or animals for their food. Yes, so here what animal, this animal nutrition, what is mean by nutrition? You have studied in your first lesson. Yes, what is the meaning of nutrition is here? It is a mode of taking food and its utilization. Nutrition means what? The mode of taking food and how we can utilize in our body. This process which we are called as what? That is nutrition. Yes. So the nutritional requirements of the body and how animals can utilize their food in our body. Yes. So this is what we call, that is animal nutrition. So in first lesson you have we have discussed that is what? Animal plant nutrition. Yes. How plants can prepare their own food. So what about the animal nutrition is here? So we will discuss more about in this topic, that is how animals can utilize the food. Yes. So you have also learned, you know about the components of food, that you have learned this in class 6. Yes. So the components of the food are what? The vitamins, proteins and minerals. These are all what? These are the proteins, vitamins, minerals. These are all what? The components of food. Yes. So the question is that these are what? These are all component. These all components are the complex substance. Yes, these are the nutrients are complex substance. Then we need to make it as our body cannot digest directly these components. Yes, why? Because our body does not have the capacity to these components directly. For that purpose, we need to make it as a simpler substance. How we can make it as a simpler? By the process of digestion. What? By the process of digestion. So we can make this complex nutrients into simpler nutrients by the process of digestion. Yes. So different ways of taking food. Yes. So what is that? The mode of taking food into the body varies in different organisms. How? See, bees and hummingbirds suck the plant and nectars, and infant of humans and some animals feed on mother's milk. Yes, snakes such as python consume the animals upon which they prey, and even aquatic animals, it also have the mode of taking food is different. Aquatic animals filter small food particles and floating close by and feed on them. So what is it? The mode of taking food in the body, into the body, varies in different organisms. Yes. So what is mean by digestion is here? Digestion, which means the breakdown of complex components. Here complex components means what? Just now we have studied, that is what? Proteins, carbohydrates, these are all what? These are all the components, that is proteins, vitamins, carbohydrates and minerals. These are all what? These are all complex components. These are what? Complex components. See, of the food which cannot be utilized by our body directly. These complex components are there, no? These cannot be utilized our body. So for that purpose, we need to make it as a simpler and absorbable substances is called as what? Digestion. Yes. So this is the process of digestion. We can make its complex component in components into simpler and absorbable substance. So this process which we are called as what? Digestion. Yes. So this is our digestion process in our human body. We can call it as also that is animal elementary canal. Okay. The digestive system of human body, we can also call it as what? Elementary canal. Yes. So this is our elementary, that is digestion in, this is the structure of what? The elementary canal or the digestive system of human body. Okay. So what are the parts including it? That is mouth, pharynx, esophagus. This is what? This is esophagus. This is mouth. This is the pharynx that you are seeing here. Yes, so this is what pharynx and the stomach. See, this is the stomach and the small intestine. This is what? The small intestine and the large intestine. And also the last below part, that is what? Nectar, that is rectum and anus. So these are the, this is what the elementary canal of the, that is elementary canal, we can also call it as what? Digestive system of human body. Okay. See, our digestion process start with the first, that is what? Mouth and buccal cavity. What? Mouth, and we take in food through the mouth and digest and utilize it. The unused parts of the food are defecated. So this is what the, we take food through the mouth. How we can take the food? Through the mouth. So what we call to this process, that is what? Ingestion. What we call? Ingestion. So this is what? Ingestion. Yes, sir. What is ingestion means? The process of taking food into the body is called what? Is called ingestion. Okay. So, next is what? Afterward, after the taking food, what will happen? We need to see the body which after taking the food, we chew the food with the teeth and break it down mechanically into the small pieces. Yes. So after the taking food, what we will do? We will chew the food. Okay. We chew the food and we will break down the food into small pieces. That is what? The mechanical process. How? With the help of teeth. With the help of teeth. Yes. See, this is possible by the part that is what? Buccal cavity. Okay, the buccal cavity, which means what? The cavity of a mouth, the cavity of the mouth with all its internal parts, like that is cheeks. See what? The cavity of a mouth with all its internal parts like cheeks, teeth, tongue and salivary glands is called as buccal cavity. See, after the taking food, the next part, that is what? Buccal cavity. Okay, buccal cavity. Here is our buccal cavity. Okay, so in this buccal cavity, what will happen? These are the teeth with which help us to make our food pieces, which helps to break down the food, yes, into small pieces. Yes. And also, so this buccal cavity includes the parts, that is internal parts, that is cheeks, teeth, tongue and salivary glands, which we are called it as what? Buccal cavity. So first process is what? We need to digest our food, means we should take the food inside and we should break down into small pieces. Yes. So with the help of this buccal cavity we can make that process. Yes. So this elementary canal is there, no? The elementary canal, that is the digestive system of human body, begins with this buccal cavity. Okay, so our digestive system is there, no? It is begins with this buccal cavity. Okay, see the inner walls of the stomach and small intestine, that is, so here what? The elementary canal and digestive begins from the buccal cavity. So first what will happen with the help of our body? With the help of this buccal cavity, after chewing the food, what will happen? We can make into small pieces. Yes. So with the help of few certain, that is salivary glands, which are present in our mouth. Okay. Which are present in our mouth, which help us to make the complex substance into simpler substance. See, our buccal cavity includes, these are the some parts, that is cheeks, okay. So buccal region, that is inner lip, okay. So these are the palatine tonsil, hard palate and outer lip. What are these? These are the different parts, internal parts of this whole buccal cavity, okay. So after, what will happen when we take it food, we chew the food into smaller and break down into small pieces, and we convert what? The digest, that is our body absorb, that is our mouth, this part which absorb the complex substance, that is nutrients which are present in the food. Okay, and we can make, it will convert into the simpler substance with the help of salivary glands which is present in our mouth. Okay, and even these salivary glands which are also present in our stomach also. Okay, and also the mouth. So in this mouth, these salivary glands which help us to convert the complex substance into simpler substance. Okay, see our teeth is there, no? Our teeth vary in appearance and perform different functions accordingly, they are given in different names. Okay, here is there, no? So these are the what? Incisors. Yes, incisors, canines, okay, premolar and molars. Okay, these are the different parts of the teeth. Okay, see our teeth vary in appearance and perform different functions. Okay, so these are the parts are there, no, which have the different functions. For example, here what? Molars. So which help us to grinding the teeth, present only in adults. Okay, these are what? Present, these molars which are present only in adults, which helps to grinding teeth, which helps to grinding and teeth, we, this type of a teeth which are present only in adult. And these are what? See, these are incisors. Okay, which help us to cutting and biting the teeth, which helps to cutting the any food which we eat, no, which with the help of these incisors we can cut the things. Yes. And these what? Premolars, grinding and chewing. Okay, these premolars which helps to grind the food and also helps to chew the food, which help us to chew the food. And also that is canines, that is which help us to piercing and tearing the teeth. Okay, so these are the different parts of the teeth with help which play a different role in our mouth. Okay, see, do you remember about the falling of your teeth some years ago? Yes. So the first step of teeth growth during infancy and they fall of the age between 6 to 8 year. So these are what? Milk teeth. When you are in child, no, at that time you have a milk teeth. Okay, the teeth which have, no, that are called as what? Milk teeth. Afterwards what will happen? In 7 or 8 years the teeth are fall down. Yes. So after falling the teeth, new teeth will come, no? The teeth which we are called as what? Permanent teeth. Okay, so we can see the two kinds of teeth. That is what? One is milk teeth, another one is permanent teeth. Okay. In childhood, when you are growing, no, at that time the teeth grow, no, that kind of a teeth which we are called as what? Milk teeth. Okay, that teeth which is called it as what? Milk teeth. When that teeth fallen, afterwards new teeth will comes, no, that we will call it as what? That is what? That is what? Permanent teeth. So this is our the first part, that is what? Buccal cavity. So this buccal cavity, with the help of this buccal cavity, we can digest, that is we can make the, we can cut the food into smaller pieces and here absorb the nutrients from the food, and it will turns into the complex to the simpler substance. Okay, afterwards, after the cutting food, after making the smaller piece, that food will be passes through this esophagus, that is what? Food pipe. So this is called what? Esophagus. So here the process will, what is the process here takes place? That is cutting food. Yes, breakdown of food into smaller pieces. Okay, so the salivary gland which is present in this part, no, it absorbs the nutrients from the food, and that food to be transport this through esophagus. What? Esophagus. Yes. Okay, so esophagus is the part of the digestive elementary canal which helps to the swallowed food passes into the swallowed food means what? The digested food. Okay, the food, the swallowed food passes into the esophagus which runs along the neck and the chest. Okay, the food is pushed down by the movements of the walls of the food pipes. This movement takes place throughout the alimentary canal to push the food downwards. Okay, so here is the part that we that you are seeing. This is what? Esophagus. Okay, which helps to food to downwards. The swallowed food means the digested food to be, which help, this esophagus helps to push down. Okay, see, this is about the first part, that is what? The mouth and the buccal cavity. Next, what? Stomach. Okay, see, stomach, it is a thick wall and bag like structure. It is a thick walled and bag like structure, and it obtains the food from the food pipe and opens into the small intestine towards the other openings. Okay, see, the stomach, which is a thick walled bag, it will get food through the esophagus. Yes, the swallowed food which transported through the esophagus, and through esophagus it will transport it to the esophagus, transport the digested food, that is swallowed food, into the where it transport? It transport to the stomach. Okay, see, here is our stomach. So through this esophagus transport the swallowed food into the where? The stomach. Yes, see, so the inner lining of stomach produce mucus and hydrochloric acid and other digestive juices. Yes, so the swallowed food transport through the esophagus, no, esophagus, afterwards it the our stomach is there, no, it this stomach release hydrochloric acid. What? Which release the acid that we are called as what? Hydrochloric acid. Yes, and also the digestive juice which are present in our food. So in our mouth or in our stomach also there is a certain kinds of juices produced. Through that juices which helps to digest the food. Digesting food means what? Absorbing the nutrients from food and which make it into the simpler substance. Okay, we need to absorb the so our body absorb the nutrients through water, and it will convert complex to the simpler substance. This is the process which we are called it as what? Digestion. Yes, So how can they digest it? With the help of what? With the help of this digestive juice and salivary glands. Okay, best example, see here our body release hydrochloric acid. Okay, this hydrochloric acid is there, no? Which helps to, which converts into the, that is the food into the simpler substance and also the digestive juices. Okay, so the food is churned into semi-solid mass in the stomach. Okay, our food is there, no? It will churned into the, churned means what? Grinder means tiny, smally, that is the semi-solid mass like, okay? So in our stomach. So the enzymes which are present in the gastric juice which disintegrate the food, which help us to disintegrate the food. See, the stomach is a thick walled bag and its shape is like a flattened or J, and it is widest part of the alimentary canal. Our stomach is there, no? It is the widest part of the canal, that is alimentary canal, and it receives food from the food pipe at one end and opens into the small intestine at the other end. So the inner lining of stomach secretes mucus, hydrochloric acid and digestive juices. So this mucus protects the lining of the stomach. So the acid which helps to kill many bacteria that enter along with the food and makes the medium in the stomach acidic and helps the digestive juices to act. So the hydrochloric acid which is present in our food now, which releases in our food, which help us to kill the bacteria. Okay. So the digestive juice break down the proteins into the simpler substance. So that I have already told that the juices which are secreted in our body, which help us to make the simpler substance. Okay, that is carbohydrates which converts into the simpler substance, which is, what is the simpler form of carbohydrates? That is what? That is starch. Okay, so in last class you have discussed in, that is in first, in first lesson you have studied that what the simpler substance of carbohydrate is, what? Starch. Okay, which is convert in the form of starch. So likewise proteins also converted in the form of simpler substance. What is the simpler substance of carbohydrate? That is proteins is here, that is what? Amino acids. The simpler substance of proteins is here what? Amino acids. Okay, see here I told you that hydrochloric acid which helps in partial digestion of proteins and also kills harmful bacteria. Okay, see this hydrochloric acid is there, no? Which helps in partial digestion. Partial digestion means what? Not completely. Okay, the digestion still is there. Okay, and proteins and also kills harmful bacteria. So next what? So it will open, so after the swallowed food reach the stomach and it will opens with what? Small intestine. Yes, so in this small intestine what? This is a highly coiled organ of a 7.5 meter length. Okay, so this is the very largest organ in our body. It is 7.5 meters length. Okay, so it receives secretion from the liver and pancreas. So liver is there, no? This is liver. Liver is the biggest part of the human body. Okay, so the complete digestion and absorption of food takes place in the small intestine, where I have told that in stomach what will happen. In stomach the digestion process will be partial, not completely. Okay, so and also the hydrochloric acid which kills the harmful bacteria. The complete digestion process takes place in where? In the small intestine with the help of what parts? This liver and pancreas. Okay, with the help of this liver and pancreas. So the complete digestion and absorption of food takes place in small intestine. See, the inner walls of the intestine have a finger-like outgrowth which we are called as what? Villi. Okay, small intestine is there, no? it have the small finger like outgrowth structures, okay, which we are called as what, villi. Okay, so this villi increases the surface area of the absorption of food. Okay, it help us to the increases the area, increase the surface area of the absorption of food. So each villus has a small network of blood vessels. Okay, the complete digestion process takes place in the small intestine, and this small intestine has the inner walls, that is the, it has the inner walls, the small finger like structure, which we are called as what, villi. What its function? The function of villi is which increases the surface area for absorption of food. Okay, so each villus has a small network of a blood vessels. It has the network with the blood vessels, and absorbed food by villi and is transferred to the body via through the blood vessels. So absorbed nutrients, which is takes place in with the help of liver and pancreas. Okay, so the absorbed nutrient, this nutrients could be absorbed by the villus. Okay, it has a finger like structure and it absorb the food, and it will connect these finger like structure connected to the blood vessels. Okay, so through these blood vessels, the digested food transport to the all parts of the body. So this is about what, small intestine. Next we will go to large intestine. See, in large intestine it is wider and shorter than small intestine. See, here I told you, know, liver and pancreas. Okay, these are the two. Liver is the biggest part of the human body. Yes, so in this liver there is another type of in this liver the juice to be secreted, that we are called as what, that is bile juice. What? Bile juice. Okay, this bile juice which helps to digest the food. Okay, which digestion means which convert the bile juice, which convert into the complex substance into simpler substance. Okay, next we will go to the another one part, that is what, large intestine. So it is a wider and shorter than the small intestine. It is 1.5 meter in length. See, the absorption of water and salt from the undigested food occurs in the large intestine. So the remaining waste matter is passed out through the rectum. Okay, see, afterwards what in small intestine the food get completely digested. Okay, the remaining waste will be present in that, no, it will release from that waste product is there, no, that will be come out through this large intestine. Okay, so the absorption of water and salt from undigested food occurs in the large intestine, and the remaining waste matter is there, no, it is passed out through the rectum, and time to time fecal matter is removed through the anus. This is what we are called as what, excretion. Excretion means what, which is the rid out waste material from our body, which we are called as what, excretion. See, this is the anus. The anus is the opening at the end of the human digestive tract, and the removal of fecal matter means what, waste matter from the large intestine occurs through the anus, and this process which we are called as what, excretion. Excretion means what, removing the waste matter from our body, and which we are called it as what, anus. See, I told you that saliva and salivary glands. Yes, what are these saliva and salivary glands? The three pairs of salivary glands are present around the mouth, and they pour their secretion, that is saliva, into mouth by a salivary ducts. See, saliva has a mucus and salivary amylase. So these saliva and salivary amylase is there, no, which help us to make the substance, that is complex, into the simpler substance. So mucus, which helps to the See, mucus which helps in easy passage of food through the food pipe. The mucus which produced in our mouth, no, which help us to the passage of food through the food pipe. It will make easy to transport swallowed food to the through the food pipe. Okay. Next is what? Salivary amylase is an enzyme responsible for breaking of starch content of food into the simpler sugar. See, this salivary, the jelly like substance which is present in our mouth, no, that we are called it as what? Saliva. Okay, this salivary, that is salivary amylase is there, no? This is the enzyme. This is a type of a enzyme which is responsible for the breaking of starch content of food into the simpler sugar. Starch means here what? Starch is the simpler, that is, it is in the form of carbohydrates. Yes, it will make it to the sugar. Here is starch is there, no? Starch is the complex substance, whereas sugar is the simpler substance. This is the how process of digestion takes place in our body. See, and gallbladder. What is this gallbladder? I told you that liver is the biggest part in our body. Yes, sir. So in that liver is biggest part in our body. In that liver, the bile juice is produced. Okay, that bile juice is there, no? That is stored in the gallbladder, which is present in our body. So the gallbladder is a small pear shaped. This is the small pear shaped organ which is present under the liver on the right side of the body, and it stores bile juice secreted by the liver. Okay, see, bile plays an important role in the digestion of fats. Okay, see, that saliva which is present in our mouth, now that it helps to convert the starch into the sugar. Likewise, so this bile juice is there, no, it will play important role in the digestion of fats. In the digestion of fats, fats is what? Fat, which is nothing but the component of food. Okay, this fatness to be convert into the simpler substance with the help of bile juice. See, this digestion process takes place by the process of absorption and assimilation in small intestine. Where in small intestine? See, the digested food is taken up by the blood vessels lining and small intestine's wall. So this process of phenomenon which we are called it as what? Absorption. See, the digested food is, you know, it is taken up by the blood vessels lining the small intestine's wall. Okay, so this is what we are called as what? Absorption. Absorbing, the absorption takes place where? In the small intestine. How? By the blood vessels. This process of absorbing nutrients from the small intestine, that we are called it as what? Absorption. So the inner walls of small intestine have the small finger like outgrowth structure which we are called as what? Villi. These villi is which helps to increase the area of the small intestine. So the substance that are absorbed are transported through the blood vessels to the various organs of the body, where it is utilized to build up complex substance into the simpler substance, like proteins essential for the body. This is called as what? Assimilation. Assimilation is a process that which helps to absorb the transported through a blood vessels. Through assimilation is the process which is nothing but transport the digested food to the different parts. Okay, the process which we are called it as what? Assimilation. Okay, in simpler way we can know it the meaning of this assimilation, which is nothing but what? The transport the digested food into the all parts of the body. This process of which we are called it as what? Assimilation. So this